Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I wanted to come quickly and just talk to you about my 60-day juice feast that I am embarking on. And as I sit here, I'm like, what is the matter with you? Why would you do something so stupid? This is what's going on in my head. I'm like, are you kidding me? What are you doing? So I've got my first juice of the day. What have I done? Like, why am I doing this? This is what I'm thinking to myself. I'm just being real, y'all. Y'all know I drink juice all the time. This is my thing. Juicing does put your body in a position where it can heal itself naturally, but something needs to happen up here for me and right here for me to not be freaking out because I'm not gonna chew food for 60 days. Now, I'm being a little bit dramatic. I'm going to be okay. The longest juice fast that I have done in my life has been 40 days. And I made it. I didn't die. I actually was better for it. And I didn't even do it right at the time. So what am I tripping over? So this juice is a hot juice. It is a combination of a lot of fruits and, well, a lot of vegetables like celery, cilantro, green leafy greens, all different types of leafy greens. I got lemon and apples. And the thing that is causing it to be hot is a habanero. I put one habanero in a huge batch of juice. So it's kind of hot. So I'm still tripping, y'all. Why am I even making this video? So anyway, as some of you know, last week, and I'm looking down because I want to refer to my notes and I don't want to forget to tell you guys something. I did the 3 days fasting and praying last week, and it was wonderful. There were lots of revelations, healings, and insights that came out of that time of fasting and praying. And one of those insights was that I was to continue on juicing and fasting and praying. So if at all you want to join me in the praying piece of this process, you can go down in the link in the description below and join my fasting and praying Facebook group. That's where I'll be praying for an hour each day of the next today in the next 59 days. So we already did our prayer for today, but you can join and you're able to go in and watch the prayer if you missed it. But on my YouTube channel, I'm going to be documenting my physical journey for the juice feast. So I am going to be drinking at least 1 gallon of juice every day. That's what I'm going to be shooting for. It is not to deprive myself or anything like that. This is to flood my body with minerals and nutrients that my body needs, and I'm going to do it for the next 60 days. There are some personal reasons that I am doing this fast that I'm not going to really discuss on this channel right at the moment. I'll probably uncover some of those reasons after the fast is over. But some physical reasons that I am fasting is because I have an issue going on with my eye. I don't know if you guys have seen it before, but if you look at this eye, it is somewhat inflamed. Now, I don't believe that there is anything literally wrong with my eye. Like, I don't have a disease or anything with my eye. But what I think is going on is that some of the detoxing I have been doing over the last, you know, few months has caused this eye to start to try and push some of the toxins out. Because I'm feeling some things in my ear, on the outside of my ear, behind my ear, as well as this eye. Like, I'll wake up in the morning, it'll be completely pus filled and closed. And that's just a sign of toxicity trying to come out. The body will try to eliminate toxins any way it can, and this happens to be my eye. So I want to give my body a break so my body can push whatever this toxic waste is in my eye out. And When I was a little girl, I used to get styes on my eye, and I believe this is the eye that I got my first dye on. And if you don't know what a stye is, it's like a little pimple or something like that that grows on your eyelid, and it swells and gets inflamed and it hurts. So I used to get those all the time. That should have clued my mother in when I was a kid that I was toxic. But I mean, lots of kids get styes on their eyes, and the doctor either gives them some type of antibiotic or medication or some type of ointment or something like that to try and clear it up. But really, if you're getting styes on your eye, it's because toxicity is in your body and you need to cleanse. When I was a kid, I drank lots of dairy, lots of whole milk. I lived on a lot of cereal because I was home alone by myself a lot when I was younger, so I couldn't cook. We didn't have a microwave when I was little, so it was either you made a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, or you drank, I mean, you ate cereal and milk. So that was a lot of what I did. And I was very mucousy when I was a kid. And I got lots of ear infections. As a matter of fact, I had gotten my tonsils and adenoids taken out because of all of the infections that I used to get when I was little. And at one point, my tonsils grew back. Can you believe that? And so I don't know if adenoids can grow back, but definitely tonsils can grow back. Thankfully, I'm glad I have them, because you need your tonsils, because those are where your lymph nodes are residing. It helps you to get rid of toxic waste in your body. So thankful that the body is smart enough to do that, but don't know about the adenoids. But all I know is that I was always at the eye, ear, nose, and throat clinic at the University of Pittsburgh Hospital. Back then it was called Children's Hospital. That's where I grew up, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and I was always at the hospital, and due to mucus. And I think that is what's going on with his eyes. Finally, all that stuff is trying to come out of my head. And through this juice feast, I'm going to work on getting some of this stuff out of my head. That's one thing that I'm going to be working on. And two, I'm going to be working really closely at cleaning out my digestive system. That is one the other reason that I'm doing it, because even though I've done a lot of work over the last few years about clearing my body out, I need to do work on my digestive system. And juice feasting is one of those ways that I'm going to be doing it. So about a week before I did the fasting and prayer challenge that we did last week, I started getting this inkling that I was supposed to juice fast. And I felt like it was supposed to be 60 days, but I was like, forget that. I'm not doing that. I just don't want to do it. And you know what it was? It was because it was up here. It was like I didn't want to let go of the chewing aspect of eating. Like, I was eating healthy, but I just wanted to chew. And there's a connection. That's addiction. If you can't lay down food for a day, a week, 50 days, 60 days, and drink it instead of eating it, that's a problem. That's another layer of addiction. There's the addiction where, you're eating foods, you can't stop eating them even though they're hurting your body. But if you can't make a decision to do a fast or a feast in this case because you're too worried about chewing food, that's a problem. I don't want anything to have that much control over my life. So that's another reason why, even though I'm freaking out right now, I'm still gonna press into this, because there's something that I believe that I need to get delivered from if I'm freaking out that much. I don't really have any like physical ailments like I used to have, so I'm just gonna let my body do what it's gonna do. But I'm hoping that through this process that I'll be able to clear this eye out, and that I'll be able to clear my digestive tract out. And that's hence the reason for the amount of juice that I'm going to be drinking. So I'm going to shoot for, like I said before, a gallon of juice a day. And the other thing is I'll be taking herbs for cleansing my colon and my whole digestive tract, supporting my digestive tract, mostly in liquid form. I teach the How to Cleanse the Colon in my coaching program. So if you're interested in learning how to do that, you can either send me an email, info@whatchelseaeats.com, or go to my website and look at my Work With Me page, and then you can see the types of things that I do. If you want to join me on this juice feast, you're welcome to do that. If you have a juicer, just start juicing. Just make sure that you're drinking enough juice in a day. And usually 3 liters of juice is enough for the average woman. But if you're looking to really stay hydrated, and you're looking to try to heal something, and you want to stay satiated, that 4th liter of juice is probably a good idea to at least have on hand in case you need it every day. If you're a man, you can drink 2 gallons of juice a day, or 1.5 gallons of juice, and it will be no problem. You can juice using a juicer, and you can juice using a blender. Let me tell you what the difference is. First, if you have a juicer, you're going to put the vegetables and fruit through the juicer, and it's going to extract just the liquid and separate the pulp. If you're using a blender to juice, what you have to do is put the fruits and vegetables in the blender, blend them, and then strain the juice off the pulp. You could use a nut milk bag to do that. You can go on Amazon and get a nut milk bag. Just type in nut milk bag and they'll come up. Or you can use a fine mesh strainer. It's a fine mesh strainer to drain off the juice from the pulp. You can do it either way. You don't have to go buy a juicer, but I recommend that if you are going to do this kind of juice feast or juice fast, a juicer would be a better option. It's going to make your life a lot easier. The 2 juicers that I recommend, the one I really recommend, is the Green Star Elite. The link for that one is down below. But I am recommending another juicer that is a little less expensive, and the link is down below right next to the Green Star link. Also, if you don't want to buy a juicer, you can buy a Vitamix. And a link for the Vitamix that I use is down there. If there is a choice between the two, if you only have a choice to buy one thing, and you're trying to change your lifestyle, I would recommend buying the high-speed blender over the juicer and then saving up my coins to buy a juicer. That's what my choice would be. So if you want to follow the physical part of my fast, stay tuned on this channel, and I will share all about that here on this channel. If you want to follow my spiritual journey, you'll have to join the Facebook group in order to get that information. The other reason that I almost left out is the reason I'm doing the juice feasting is because I am also going to be doing all of my normal activities that I do every day, from working to, you know, doing things with my family to all of my regular activities. So I'm not going to stop any of that. And that's the benefit of juice feasting, because you can feast on the juice and still actually do all the things that you normally do, but you still can give your body a rest and cause the healing to happen. So anyway, I know I've been rambling, but if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, I'll talk to you soon. Take care.